All right, so let's get started here. You're watching this because you're interested in real estate, and furthermore, you're interested in the Fraser Valley real estate statistics. And that is me. I'm here to bring it to you. It's Michelle Cummins with the Cummins Real Estate Group with RE/MAX Little Oak Realty, and I am proud and happy to bring you September 2020 stats. And mark my words, the housing market activity has reached historic levels in September. I've been saying it, June, it started going up. July, crazy. August, crazy. September, crazy. So here are some words from the headmaster of the real estate board. So consumer demand for real estate in the Fraser Valley remained robust for the fourth consecutive month, with overall sales and new listings reaching record-breaking numbers in September. I have to show you right now a stat. Watch the screen. So this stat is showing you that we are in the highest priced market we have ever been in the Fraser Valley. It keeps on going up. It's just amazing. It's an amazing time to be in the Fraser Valley. It is an amazing place to be in the Fraser Valley. Last week, Curtis and I had on our Cummins Real Estate Group radio show on Country 107.1 FM, and furthermore on our podcast, if you want to listen to past episodes on my website as well. But if you're riding the treadmill or you're driving, you know, 20 minutes or more car ride and you want something to listen to, just download our podcast, Western Canada Real Estate, Fraser Valley Real Estate, Michelle Cummins, Curtis Pope. Just put us in there in your podcast and you'll find us. But you can listen to all the past episodes. So last week we talked about some amazing things we love about the Fraser Valley and why we love living in the Fraser Valley. So the Fraser Valley, on top of being an amazing place to live, is actually really good for equity growth and really good for investments and really good to live in and to buy in. So buying now under 2% interest rates, need I say more? Amazing. So get pre-approved. If you're able to buy, you can buy, you should buy. And this is a great area to buy in, so do it. Just call me and I'll help you. I'd be happy to help you. Again, if you're a seller, amazing time. So Chris Shields is the president of our board and he says our homes have never been more important. Across the Fraser Valley, we're seeing a trend towards buyers looking for more space and livability in both single family homes and townhomes. So that's been the hot market for many existing homeowners and first time home buyers. Their buying power is greater than it's been in a very long time. Interest rates are very low. People have saved money over the last few months and they're choosing to invest it in real estate. And we're happy in the Fraser Valley to see more growth and to see people loving this area and wanting to move in the area. So let's talk about single family detached homes. So right now over on the Fraser Valley, prices are at $1,032,700,000. That is the benchmark price for single family detached homes. Let's talk about townhouses. So $567,300 is the benchmark price for a townhouse in the Fraser Valley. Apartments are $436,900. That is an increase of 4.7% compared to September of last year. So pretty exciting news. Now I'm going to go into municipality by municipality because we've got five of those puppies here in the Fraser Valley. So let's talk about Abbotsford first. So Abbotsford detached homes are at $868,000. That's an increase of 9.7% from last year and 2.2% from the month before. Townhouses are $468,500, and that's an increase of 3.1% from last year and 0.7% from the month before. Condos are at $324,500, an increase of 3.9% and a decrease of 0.2% from the month before. So overall, year over year, good. Month over month, apartments not so good. Mission detached benchmark prices are at $711,700. That's an increase of 11.6% from last year and an increase of 2.1% from the month before. Townhouses in Mission are at $470,000 for the benchmark price. That's an increase of 5% from last year and an increase of 1% from the month before. Apartments are at $362,000 and that's an increase of 0.7% from last year and 1.1% from the month before. Langley, which is where I moved to when I first came to Canada in 1998, if you can believe it. Oh my gosh, I got, believe this, married on the same day as I moved to a new country, as I moved into a new place, and I started a new job. All on the same day. Yeah, that was a beautiful day in 1998. So I moved to Langley. Langley benchmark price, $1,078,000 for detached homes. That's an increase of 9.8% from last year and an increase of 1.1% from the month before. Townhouses in Langley, $576,900, increase of 4.2% from last year and 0.1% from the month before. Apartments are at $404,000, at 7% increase from last year and 0.8% increase from the month before. So then Delta detached properties benchmark prices at $946,800, an increase of 8.1% from last year, and believe it or not, another increase of 1.2% from the month before. Townhouses, $564,500, an increase of 1.5% from last year, and a decrease of 2.2% from the month before. And then we've got apartments. They're at $394,000. That's an increase of 7.7% from last year and an increase of 1.8% from the month before. Then we have Surrey. All of Surrey, it's such a big area. Benchmark price for detached homes in Surrey is at $1,127,000, an increase of 7.5% from last year and an increase of 0.9% from the month before. Townhouses in Surrey are at $591,500, an increase of 4.1% from last year and an increase of 0.8% from the month before. And apartments are at $401,800, an increase of 4.7%, but minus 0.3% from last month. So there you have it. That's the Fraser Valley Real Estate Statistics for September 2020 in a nutshell. This is Michelle Cummins, and thank you for watching my video this month. We'll see you next month, everyone. Bye for now. She's a summer girl. She's a summer girl.